Hi everyone, I'm Dima Zane. An iconic discovery, heatwave cooked shellfish, and microchip manicures. Here are five stories you may have missed, starting with pandemonium. Okay, all you panda lovers out there, China has officially declared that giant pandas are no longer an endangered species. China's Ministry of Ecology and Environment downgraded the species to vulnerable last week. What's interesting about the announcement is that the international community hasn't considered the giant panda endangered for more than 5 years. The International Union for Conservation of Nature downgraded the species to vulnerable in 2016, when it said there were 1,800 giant pandas in the wild. But China pushed back against the decision at the time, fearing their efforts to protect the species would be undermined. It's not clear why they've changed the status now, especially given the ministry said there are still only 1,800 living in the wild. But the ministry did credit its system of nature preserves, law enforcement measures, and education efforts for contributing to the decision. Chocolate child labor. Ever sit down to enjoy your favorite chocolate and wonder, where did it come from? Well, this is probably a surprise to you, but nearly two-thirds of the world's cocoa production comes from West Africa, where an estimated 1.6 million children work illegally to help harvest it. Some major companies like Nestle and Cargill have been sued unsuccessfully over claims of knowingly buying cocoa beans from farms that use child slave labor. But as our partners at PBS NewsHour Weekend reported, one company in the Netherlands is determined to help satisfy your sweet tooth ethically. Special correspondent Megan Thompson profiled Tony's Chocolonely, a chocolate company that's based entirely around fighting child labor in the industry. Chocolonely is a relatively small player in the $100 million a year industry, but they track cocoa beans to ensure they are ethically farmed and sold. And the company raised their prices to pay farmers more, since most cocoa farmers live below the poverty line. You can check out Megan's full report on our website, pbs.org/newshour. Cooked alive. The coastlines of the Pacific Northwest and parts of Canada are facing an ecological disaster in the wake of last month's record-breaking heat wave. Researchers say the series of 100-plus degree days left more than 1 billion marine animals dead. The region's normally cool, crisp waters are usually an ideal place for shellfish. Mussels and barnacles, which live where tides come in and out, can close up when it's a low tide and use the water inside their shells to keep cool. But temperatures were as high as 121 degrees in some parts of British Columbia, and that meant there was no escape for these creatures. Think of it like locking a child or a pet in the car on a hot day. Things can turn deadly quickly. It led to a catastrophic loss for the local shellfish industry as millions of oysters, mussels, clams, and other seafood cooked to death in the heat. And there could be even more dire ecological consequences. Many of those animals clean the seawater as they filter feed, and they're a major food source for seabirds and other animals. Microchip manicure. A salon owner in Dubai has a new way to keep your nails from being anything but basic with the microchip manicure. It's basically a high-tech, contactless, beauty-based solution for business cards. Lenore Beauty Lounge owner Noor Makaram developed the idea during the pandemic while thinking of ways to adhere to social distancing. Her clients upload their desired information, like social media pages, websites, or resumes, to a microchip through an application on their smartphones. Then, the nail technician glues the microchip onto their nail and covers it with a coat of their favorite nail polish color. The chips connect to other people's mobile devices once scanned, like when you use a credit card to pay for groceries with just a tap.
Now, if I'm in a loud place and I want to share my Instagram or my social media, say, my finger.
Want to switch your website to your social media handle? No problem. The app allows you to change your information as needed. According to CNN, the company has completed more than 500 microchip manicures so far. Iconic discovery. Catholic University has an intriguing legend, the legend of the missing Wizard of Oz dress. That's this iconic blue gingham dress worn by none other than Judy Garland in the 1939 classic. It was donated to the university in the 1970s by actor Mercedes McCambridge. She was a friend of Judy Garland. But the dress was lost for decades. For years, university staff searched the campus for the missing frock. But in June, Matt Ripa, who works in the drama department, was cleaning up to get ready for some renovations when he found it. The dress was hidden in a shoebox, inside a garbage bag, on top of the facility mailbox. It turned out another staff member had found it and left it for him years earlier. Lesson, people, check your mail.
He snapped some photos and took the dress to the University Archives Department, who then called the Smithsonian, home of Judy's ruby slippers. Experts at the Smithsonian's Museum of American History inspected the dress and found signs that it's likely authentic. Each dress has a few telltale signs of its authenticity: a hidden pocket for Dorothy's handkerchief on the right side, and the star's name and costume's wardrobe number written on the fabric. If Catholic University is able to verify it's the real deal, it'll be the sixth Dorothy dress surviving today. The university plans to put the dress on display in the near future. I can say I have never gotten anything that cool in the mail. It's usually bills or tickets. For the PBS NewsHour, and until next week, this is 5 Stories. Have a great weekend. Wait, one more thing. Don't forget to click here for 5 Stories. Well, another episode. Obviously, you just watched, but, you know, just click here. Get some more. 5 Stories.